Namaste. I'm here to share how you can overcome the hurdles or the challenges posed by a particular transit, especially when the transit is not favorable. I'm referring to the Jupiter transit, which has just happened, and how you can actually appease Jupiter, how you can be in tune with the cosmic energy, not be majorly affected. Definitely they have impact because they are higher beings and they vibrate in a much higher frequency than us, and they will definitely have more power. So they there is something beyond human control, and that's what I'm referring to. So there is a hierarchy. So human beings, and then Navagrahas, Sarpas are there, then Deva, Kinnaras are there, Devatas are there, Yakshas are there, Gandharvas are there. So there are different levels of existence, different kinds of beings are there. They all have an impact on us. In this video particularly, I am here to share about the Guru transit, how we can actually overcome the negative impact of Guru transit in our life by following some very simple steps. We should reach a stage where no matter what planetary transit is happening, no matter what dasha you're going through, what kind of a ruling period of which planet you're experiencing, your life should be the way you really will. So that's going to be quite a challenge. But there are some very, very simple tips. You know, once you follow those, it's very easy. So stay tuned while we watch this video on how to appease Planet Guru in very simple ways at home with almost no cost. This is Mekhala here from pujas.in. Let me start off by sharing with you some simple things, some simple practices which I follow at home, which have really helped me in building immunity and strength. Immunity and strength in terms of mental capabilities, or mentally withstanding the crisis, or being able to face the challenges, and also remain in a state of equipoise when things are very good. Everybody has challenges, and I also have gone through my own challenges, and I can say crisis, when the Jupiter transit was really bad for me. And despite of knowing how the planets work, despite of knowing, doing all the remedies, and still some challenges were there that I had to face. It was quite a crisis, I can say, on the personal front. But with Guru's blessings, I have been able to overcome that. And I have been able to get a lot of mental strength for myself. And because that's very important, you know. Everybody is very exhilarated, very happy when you have a good time. And when you actually go through a challenge, you are not so sure about how to face life at all. And you are so scared. So this is something that all of us go through. All of us go through crisis. All of us go through good and bad times. But some simple tips really help us a lot in really overcoming these problems and try to maintain some stability and equipoise during the rough times. The first thing that I have practiced, and which I would strongly recommend that you all do, is install a small Guru Pita. Guru Pita means what? It's like a pedestal. You can have any small plate, a silver plate or a bronze plate, and then install the charan padukas of the Guru. Now these charan padukas can be either silver or made of wood also. Very good wooden work carvings you get, like you can see in this image. Those can you can install whichever size you're comfortable. You can install that in your, either in your puja room or in your own private like a bedroom, or wherever you're comfortable. Any clean place which you deem as sacred, you can keep it there. And then you know, that's how you install it. And once you install, you have to install with invocation of a prayer. You could do it with the most common Guru mantra, Guru shloka. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo, Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat, param Brahma, Tasmai, Shri, Gurave, Namaha. And the next shloka, Ajnana, TimirAndhasya, JnanaAnjana, Shalaakaaya, Chakshurunmilitam, Yena, Tasmai, Shri, Gurave, Namaha. And the third shloka, Tvam Pita, Tvam Chame, Mata, Tvam Bandhustvam, Chadevata, Samsara, Pratibodhartham, Tasmai, Shri, Gurave, Namaha. These three sacred verses of Shri Guru Gita can be chanted. And I will also leave the shloka, you know, lyrics in the description box below this video. You can follow that. So in a very holy place, very sacred place, by holy and sacred, I'm referring to a place which appeals to your heart as holy and sacred. I'm not talking about the religious aspect of it at all, because Guru is connected to you at the soul level, not at the level of the religion aspect of it. But these shlokas, are because they are Sanskrit, they carry some power, and eventually when you realize the meaning of it, they will also invoke emotions in you and develop a connectivity through feelings between you and the Guru, which is why these three shlokas are chosen. So when you invoke Guru as Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara and Parabrahma Swarupa, the entire creation is there with the Guru then. Okay, you're invoking all the gods and goddesses. Then the Ajnana TimirAndhasya shloka will actually mean that, you know, we all are suffering today because of ignorance in different levels. So we have performed acts because of our ignorance, which has led to karma. And, you know, karma is definitely the root cause of suffering or enjoyment both. Now, if we start behaving in an enlightened way, which is going to take a lot of time and effort and patience and a lot of good virtues are required for it. But it's possible. We can start making an attempt. We can start heading towards the direction. So that is why Ajnana Timirandasya means, let all the darkness be removed in my life and let the eye of knowledge be open, so that every action I am able to do it gracefully with in line with dharma. Okay. Second thing is that also there are many dark areas where you can't think properly, you can't take proper decisions, you cannot fathom or assimilate whatever is happening, or you cannot accept gracefully whatever comes to you, whatever is in store, because that's why we have fears, we have stress, we have anxiety, right? All of us have that. So, which is why when we chant this Ajnana Timirandasya, all the dark areas, the areas which are cloudy, which are not clear to us, let that be cleared and let there be light of knowledge from the Guru. And who is this Guru? He's Tvam Pita, Tvam Cha Me Mata. You're my father, you're my mother, you're my bandhu, you're my sakha, friend, you're everything to me. So this kind of a feeling and emotional connectivity will really make you understand that your Guru is your soulmate, and you need to be connected to the Guru all the time, and that is what is going to empower you. And Guru here is not a physical entity. It's not Shri Shri so and so and Shri Shri something else. Guru is basically all gods put together. Guru is nothing but this universal consciousness. So that is something that we will start realizing. Now it's a word or a phrase, but eventually, when you start praying, connecting to the Guru, you will realize that Guru is the whole and soul of you. And Guru is your soulmate. That is the best way I can describe a Guru. So what I'm telling you is, install the Guru Peetha with all these feelings in a sacred place. You could install it or consecrate it anywhere you like. And then offer a glass of water. So that will remind you that the Guru is physically there. You know, when somebody comes to your house, the first thing you do is what? You offer water. So why you offer water is because you want to, it's like atithi satkar, no? So you come, oh, please come, hospitality. You want to offer, how are you, would you like to have some water? Water, then tea, coffee and things like that. So when you actually offer water, in your own subconscious mind, you'll realize that the Guru is physically there. It's not an idol. It's not a photo. So, and then what you need to do is light ghee lamps. So usually all of us light til oil lamps, which is very popular, especially in South India. But it is very, very, very auspicious to light ghee lamps, because the kind of vibrations it generates, it just cleanses the whole atmosphere. And it's very auspicious to light ghee lamps for Guru particularly. In fact, my mother would always light ghee lamps on all the days of the week, and in the morning and in the evening. And I'm very grateful to her that, you know, a lot of peace, tranquility, good vibrations were kept up at home because of that. And we also continue the same tradition by lighting ghee lamps every day, every single day, morning and evening. But I'm saying, if you want to appease the Guru particularly, consciously, if you want to make a move, please light ghee lamps on Thursdays at least, if not every day. If cost is an issue, or if actually getting into doing this is difficult for you, then at least do it on Thursdays, morning and evening. Morning after shower and evening once you are back home. It will give you a lot of peace. I'm sure after doing that, you will write as a comment below this video that definitely you saw some good results after doing that. It just cleanses the whole atmosphere. and show incense sticks or agarbattis, a good fragrance which will elevate your mood and which will cleanse the atmosphere. So choose a good fragrance made of natural materials. It will really cleanse the whole atmosphere, and you know, you just, no matter what you're going through, the whole effect changes, the mahol will change. You know, in Hindi we say mahol badal gaya. So that is exactly what is going to happen when you actually light an incense or agarbatti. Then what else do you do is, like you see here, we have Shri Sai Satcharitra, and there is Shri Guru Gita here. Like that, you could, you know, this is Shri Guru Gita. So what you could do is just have a Vyasa Peetha like this, like a very sacred pedestal, and on that you can keep these Sai Satcharitra or Guru Charitra or Guru Gita, whatever you are comfortable, you can just keep it, install it there, and show dhoop to this also. This is as good as presence of the Guru in your house. Okay, please understand that. So all this is basically connecting through feelings and bhavana. So that is something that you need to maintain throughout. Then what do you do after that is that you try to read at least a chapter of say Sai Satcharitra or Dattatreya Guru Charitra or any autobiography of a of an enlightened being. You know, when you keep it on the Vyasapitam every day, make it a point to read. That will give you a lot of strength. It will help you beat logic, because what happens is the Guru Charitras always carry actual experiences of devotees with the Guru, where they have experienced miracles, they have experienced the power of divinity or the power of their own soul, which is way beyond logic. So logically, if something is impossible, you can see that in a Guru Charitra or a Sai Satcharitra, that you know, they, the devotee has achieved that even beyond their own logic, and they have experienced wonderful results, phenomenal results. Somebody who is a barren woman has had a child, somebody who was have had no money and who's just not even able to afford a square meal a day has found a pot of gold and things like this, but with only sheer faith and dedication to the Guru and implicitly following the Guru, which is what I'm saying, that believing is one thing and trusting is another. So when you get into the trust mode, it's very easy to experience miracles in life. These planetary transits really will not matter to you. The dasha bhuktis will not matter to you. But unfortunately, it takes a lot of mental maturity, lot of mental strength, and good culture, spiritual culture. Genetically also, we should be ready. We should be prepared for, by our ancestors. If we are carrying the genes of our ancestors who are atheists, then it becomes a little difficult. You know, then you have to work harder. So which is why I'm saying that, you know, reading one chapter or one page every day will give you a lot of strength. It will prepare your mind. Your mind is like a manure. It will nourish your mind, which will start seeding all divine things. And then, you know, you will start seeing the fruits also very soon, as the seeds grow. So that's another thing that you need to do. Read one chapter every single day. If you're able to learn the Guru Gita, it is fantastic, because Guru Gita is 182 verses or shlokas. It's a conversation between Lord Shiva and Parvati. It is from the Skanda Purana and Uttarakhanda of Skanda Purana. And as far as I am aware, almost all ashrams have the practice of chanting the Guru Gita, the 182 sacred verses of Shri Guru Gita. So I am sure it's not rocket science, it's not difficult, it's very easy. If you have an inclination to learn, there will be some videos on YouTube you could learn from that. And if you want to personally learn through me, like you want personal instructions or on guidance on how to chant the Guru Gita, I am ready to do that. But you'll have to send me a message on WhatsApp that you want to learn. Every day I will send you one shloka per day. Okay, I'll send you a voice recorded note. You just listen to that a couple of times, chant it, and you send your voice recording back, so I'll know whether you're chanting it correctly and I can correct you accordingly if necessary. So I'm ready to teach Shri Guru Gita to all the viewers who are interested in learning, and absolutely there is no money or any dakshina involved in this. It's free of cost. So please learn it, so that you know it will help you. It is so powerful and it is so good in vibrations that it almost up to 40 kilometers radius from the place where you have installed your Guru Peetha, And from the place where you chant the Guru Gita, the entire place is energized and protected by the Guru Shakti, the universal consciousness, the cosmic force. So it is that powerful and it makes the whole atmosphere serene. It cleanses the atmosphere, which is why I am strongly recommending this. And we have been at home chanting Shri Guru Gita for more than, say, 15 years now. Yeah, it's more than 15 years since we've been chanting at home. We always, one of us will be chanting Guru Gita at home. And in sometimes independently, we all chant on our own. But Guru Gita is a part and parcel of our life for so many years. So you can understand with what experience I'm strongly recommending chant Shri Guru Gita to experience phenomenal results. There's so many inner powers hidden in you. You will start realizing that everything starts coming out from within you. All the inner powers, your hidden talents, your skills. You'll suddenly realize that you're so beautiful because of the continuous practice of chanting Guru Gita. But of course, there are certain norms for chanting. You have to have a particular asana made of wool, like have your own seat with an woolen cloth, and then you sit on that. And if you face a particular direction and chant, you get certain good results. So for all the four directions, there is one phala or a fruit of chanting it in a particular way. But those things are going to be instructed to you when you sign up for your learning. So this video is just giving you directions what all you need to do. So if you don't want to learn at this point of time, if you're not able to learn for some reason, I will also leave a link of our Guru Gita chanting in this description box. You can just play that video and listen to the chants every day if possible, or at least on a Thursday. Make an attempt, at least try making an attempt. Another thing that you could do is wear a kesar tilak. We all know saffron. So just grind it with the sandal paste. You get there is one grinding stone and one sandal bar. So just grind it and make sandal paste out of it and put tilak before you leave home. And some people have a problem because they go to office and they don't want people to construe them to be, you know, religious minded and things like that. They feel awkward to wear tilak and go. Maybe such people can come back and wear a tilak. And if you don't want to wear tilak, I have already given you other options. You could do that. And another time tested excellent remedy is making channa, you know, boil channa, soak channa in the night, boil it in the morning, make some, put some tadka, okay? Go and offer this as a nevedya to Guru Bhagwan in a Dattatreya temple or a Dakshinamurti temple or a Sai Mandir. If they give permission, please go and offer it as nevedyam and distribute it to devotees. Okay, make 3 kgs and distribute it to devotees on Thursdays. If the temple is, usually if a lot of devotees are visiting the temple, according to that you can make the quantity. There is no set limit that only this many kgs you have to do, nothing like that. Whatever is your capacity, start doing that. But at least a decent number of devotees you should give. Don't just give 3 devotees and come back. So be more generous and have an attitude that you want to give. So it will be nice when you're distributing, you'll feel really nice, soul satisfied that, you know, you're doing something really noble. And what you could also do is you donate yellow clothes to Guru Bhagwan. How do you do that is you can go to Sai Mandir again, offer vastra to Sai Baba once in 3 months, go to any Dattatreya temple, offer vastra there, yellow color, anything, cotton, silk, I leave it to you. Avoid polyester, okay? Or say any other synthetic you avoid. And you can also go to Dakshinamurti temple and give them vastra, okay? Offer Guru the vastra. This is also very, very important. And you could do it once in 3 months or once in 6 months, depending on your capacity, your time. But make time and do it. You'll start feeling some good changes. Most important thing is that you should develop an emotional connectivity with the Guru. How do you do that is why I gave you the option of consecrating the Guru Peetha anywhere at home is because some women have this mental constraint or family will not agree for them to go into the puja room or the puja mandir during their menstrual cycle. So they will, again, the disconnection will happen that time. So sometimes somebody has passed away, those 13 days you don't do anything, then again the disconnection. So what I want to tell you is Guru is your soulmate. Okay, when you connect to the Guru at the soul level, the body consciousness doesn't matter. Having a bath, not having a bath, having your periods and not having your periods really doesn't matter. Eating non-veg and not eating non-veg doesn't matter. So eventually, if you feel like giving up after doing all these practices, most welcome. It's good you give up. But Guru is more to do with your soul. So it should be like any moment you should be able to go in front of the Guru Pita or sit in front of the Guru Pita and talk to the Guru through your meditation. Talk to your Guru and tell what you're feeling, you know, express. So it should be like this lid of the subconscious just opens up and there's a free flow of energy between you and the Guru. So the physical aspect does not even come into the picture. It's more of your feelings, it's more of your thoughts, more of emotions, you know, more of unburdening. There is no baggage, you know, removing your baggage and things like that. So then what happens? It's a beautiful experience. So eventually you will realize that you become more and more intuitive and you will start following dharma. You will avoid performing a lot of negative karmas, which induces further suffering. And sometimes you gain mental maturity to that extent that, you know, no matter what happens, you feel like you're given some anesthesia, you know, what surgery is being performed, what is happening, somebody is cutting, piercing, you don't feel anything. If anything is happening, the backlash of karma or your suffering, you don't feel at all. That is when you realize the power of the Guru, no? That is why I'm saying the higher force has to be approached. So for every planet, there is an Adi Devata, Pratyadi Devata. But when you go to the Guru, Guru is all Devatas put together. This is a very good practice even for people who don't have a physical Guru. So eventually what will happen is they will start, they will be so blessed that a physical Guru will walk into your life, manifest into your life to guide you personally. Do this, do that, don't do this, don't do that. Then it's really wonderful, isn't it? So right now we are not sure whom to go to, what to do, whom to ask, who's this person who's going to guide me in my life, should I ask my parents, should I talk to my friend, I'm totally perturbed and confused. So we talk to everybody, we don't get solution. But if we make it a habit to talk to the Guru in front of the Guru Pita, the Guru Shakti, the cosmic force, Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara, every single day, 5 minutes spend time with the Guru, you see a phenomenal change in your life, and these transits really do not matter. So that is the intention of creating this video, so that, you know, all of us are empowered to a great extent. But let us not be depending on an astrologer, let us not be depending on any external force, you know, overly. I'm saying you take the help of an astrologer, take the help of your family, take the help of your friends, timely. But you know, once they give you a suggestion, even to carry it out, you need that mental grit and determination. That we lack when we are in a situation where, you know, we don't know how to go about it and we're not sure. We definitely lack that grit and determination or willpower. That is when we need help, which is why I'm saying that planetary transits can create a lot of negative impact in our mind. But what is most important is that we are very, very mentally stable, able and capable. And definitely at that time, what happens is the Guru will make people around you talk to you in the highest and best way. How would I say that is, like you will be walking, assume you have a bad transit, so you know, you're going through a rough patch and you're just walking around, you're talking to your friend, you're doing something. Suddenly they will speak something which will make sense to you. And that time you'll know it's your Guru talking to you through that person in a physical way. Because sometimes if you're not intuitive, you may not be able to receive the message of the cosmos. That time what do you do is, when we're talking to people normally and somebody says something like that, and the moment they speak to you in a certain way, in a certain tone, good or bad, whatever, stern, it could be pleasingly, in any way, the moment you hear that, you know it's not that person talking, you know it's your Guru talking to you. The Guru is trying to tell you something. You better follow that. Then you immediately quickly come to terms with what's happening and you're able to move forward. All that I'm sharing now is based on my personal experience. I've had many people help me in many, many ways, in the most unexpected ways, because my Guru, although I have my Guru in the physical form, many times I'm being guided even in the subtle forms through people. That's why I'm saying keep your eyes, ears open, and most importantly your heart, you should be open, because when you're open, you know, you're not allowing your ego to function, you're open to receiving people's suggestions, ideas, advice, and most importantly you'll understand that everybody is contributing to your growth. And nobody, because I always hear people saying, you know, this person has an axe to grind, she's doing this to me, he's doing that to me, and people often complain to me when they call, when they have to share about their problem. What I want to say is that your whole attitude will change, and you'll realize that if somebody is doing something to you, they're contributing to your growth, because you are in the hands of the Guru, you're in the lap of the Guru now. So nobody can do something wrong to you. If anything is happening at all, it is only for your good, and it will continue to be for your good. That is the beauty of this whole experience of installing the Guru Peetha, consecrating the Guru Peetha, Guru Charan Paduka is at home, and being connected most importantly. And don't be guilty if you're traveling somewhere and you're not able to light ghee lamps or things like that, because the Guru is it's a much higher force than you can even imagine. So the Guru is not mean-minded, hey, you didn't light ghee lamps today, tomorrow I'm going to punish you. It's not like that. The connectivity between you and the Guru is most important. Whether you're in India, you're abroad, you're traveling, absolutely makes no difference. The connectivity is important. But when you are at home, whichever part of the world you're in, when you're at home, make it a point to have this kind of a discipline, because physically your environment is cleansed, and which is very important. A house which is cluttered, a house which is dirty, gives you a very bad feeling. As soon as you enter, you'll also start feeling like that. But if you enter a house which is very clean, spick and span, you feel so good. Don't you realize the difference between a 5-star hotel and a normal 2-star or a budget hotel? You would know the difference, no? You enter a 5-star hotel, you feel so good because everything is in place. The best things are in place. So you feel so good. You know, that mood is created. In the same way, when in your home should be like that. Should be like so sacred that the moment you enter your house, you should be able to drop all the mental baggage on your own without any effort. It should be an automatic process. You should not feel like, why did I come home? Office is a problem and home is another. You should not feel like that. So this whole establishing the Guru Peetha at home will make your home also as sacred as a temple. Okay, don't be guilty if you have habits. I drink at home, I eat non-veg at home, we cook non-veg at home, so I can't install a Guru Peetha. Don't have that feeling. So my Guru always says everybody is eligible for enlightenment. That's what my Guru says time and again, irrespective of your religion or your caste, because it's a state of mind, a state of existence. It has nothing to do with you in the physical form, how you're born and things like that. So in your house, no matter what habits you're having at home, find a suitable place for that. I'm sure there will be a corner which will be very sacred. So just find that corner, and you see that in your heart only you're making space for the Guru, most importantly. So automatically everything, the whole house will be transformed into a temple or into a very sacred place. With this, I would like to conclude today's video. I'll see you soon. Namaste.